I'd really like to talk to you. You ready now?
Of course. Anything you need.
Anything I need, huh? I might take you up on that one day. After Tommy stuck me with you, I was expecting to hate your guts. Not only because you agreed to pick up me contract, but because I was waiting for you to order me around like hired help. Now, so far, you've been treating me like a friend. Hell, you've been damn near nice to me. Now, I don't mean to sound ungrateful, but your kindness is starting to make me wonder. If there's anything I learned in the combat zone, it was that nobody does things for other people without expecting something in return.
Surviving the combat zone must have been rough.
That's putting it nicely. I spent 3 years living at the combat zone. Smelled like puke and piss. But I called it home. I was making a few caps. Had me own bed to sleep in and 3 hot meals a day. Then the raiders took over the place. You know that lot. They aren't exactly what you'd call the gentle type. After they moved in, if you didn't keep looking over your shoulder, you were liable to get sucker punched or robbed. Or worse. Didn't take me long to learn that I had to put my hard-earned caps to good use. Buying friends was essential to making life easy. So, I guess I'm waiting for you to hand me a bill. You know what I mean?
You don't owe me a thing.
Now I'm having a real hard time believing that. I'll tell you what. Give me some time and I'll think of something I can do to repay you. I'm not a rich girl, but I'm sure we can agree on something. After all, what are friends for?
Good morning. I'm Michael Green, the counter jockey. And it's definitely not morning here. It is definitely nighttime here, but morning where you are. Unless you're watching it after it goes live, or more than a couple. You get what I mean? So, for this morning's episode, we are gonna go check out a place that I remember heading to. I know that I completed the story that's in it, and I could not tell you what happened for the life of me. Probably because I also played it late at night the last time. So, you know, repeating mistakes and all that. We're heading to the Witchcraft Museum. I don't feel like fighting an entire quarry full of raiders right now. So, we're gonna sneak around that shit. I say we. Oh, there she is. Come on, Cait. Just thick with raiders out here. Trying to do it quietly. Oh! Oh god! No, 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 no. Ugh.
Gotta be something of value on him.
I've never seen that happen. In all the hours I've played this game, I've never had that happen. It honestly made me sick. A little bit. Just enough to remind me that, you know, games can cause visceral reactions. Let's clear my head. Let's go figure out who the hell's shooting at who. Ooh, lasers. knows how much ammo I'm gonna need for this.
Whoa, whoa. You hear that?
Yeah, it's gunfire. One thing I should probably do, should throw my helmet back on. Oh, that was a lucky get. I wish there was a go prone button.
Come on. You mean that's it?
Ooh. That was bananas.
Hey.
Tell the good doc what's wrong with you. Spend your caps, and I'll make it all better.
Not today.
Fine.
Ooh. You guys know how to pick a fight. Let's just go ahead and... Oh, actually, I wonder if I can loot all these guys and get to him fast enough to just vendor all of it. Run around. Loot. Quickly. Oh. A little slow for some of these guys. The frickin' Rust Devils have been... like... as soon as you unlock them as part of the story, they have been flipping everywhere. Just terrorizing the folks. Okay. Where'd the good doctor go? Okay, I'll give them credit. That's funny. The doctor named his Brahmin idiot. Hey, look, a pile of a raider. Powdered raider. It's all the rage.
Doc.
Tell the good doc what's wrong with you. Spend your caps, and I'll make it all better.
Tell you what, how about you spend your caps?
Actually, I need some supplies for the road.
You got the caps, I got the goods.
Next Fallout game, I want there to be a guy that's all he does, is he travels from place to place, and he just buys anything you will sell him. He's just like, yeah, no, I'll take that. Yep, I'll take that too. Sure, why not? And just loads up on all your junk. Ooh, actually, before I get rid of all of those... maybe not the Long Johns. Yeah, I think I'll sell the robot gear too. There we go. Not a bad little haul from just like bumping into a fight. Huh. And here we go. The place we were heading to. Pack of cigarettes, but not one that's used.
Chained on the other side.
Interesting. Well, the tip I got said there could be some really good stuff here. Oh. Huh. Somebody didn't have a good time. Let's see
Jeffrey,
what this says.
Lee got the recorder working. So this is the sort of detail you had in mind when you signed up for the Gunners? Hauling luggage from Lynn Woods for some robot butler? What was his name? Wellington? Wellingham?
Not now, Private. Where's Connors? He's not at his post.
Oh, sorry, sir. The lieutenant said he found some tracks. Wanted to check them out. Private Martin.
Tracks? What tracks? What the hell is that?
Oh, my... Connors! Where's the rest of him?
Jesus. Found us. Sergeant Lee, grab the case. Do not let that thing out of your sight. Everyone inside the museum, now!
Major! Major, what found us?
Yeah, sure, this is safe. This is fine and safe and smart, this thing I'm doing. You know, let's just go in the spooky, scary building, where we know a bunch of tough marine types ran away from a giant scary mo-
That sounds bigger than a mole rat.
No fucking shit, Cait. You know something I'm discovering about myself? When I get a little bit spooked out, I think I get a little thwary.
Sweet.
I need to get a swear jar.
It's just garbage. I toss it.
Get one of those like...
Shite. I'm gonna be jumping at the goddamn shadows next. If you think this is bad, you should see some of the blokes I beat up at the combat zone.
Oh, I dare say, Cait, this is worse than something you did at the combat zone. Just gonna throw that out there. The fact that I'm about to poop myself, probably a little worse.
Nice.
Batten down the hatches and all. A lot of vectors, Cait. Keep your eyes open.
If I find you,
oh. Oh shit. Okay. That's fair. That's fair. I thoroughly expected to die. Okay. Now we're just Dark Souls it. We know what we're up against. My shotgun does, in two shots, more than what a rocket launcher does. Though, I have a feeling this ignores more armor. But, this causes them to bleed. And if it bleeds, we can kill it. But seriously. Are my grenades equipped? Because I've been fucked by this before. Oh, Cait, we are badasses. Oh shit, still moving. Cait, you gotta be careful, man. We totally somehow pulled that off. I think we can successfully call that one Batmaned. Wait. Oh.
Maybe if we just return the eggs. this.
That's rough. Was a pissed off mama Deathclaw. Oh, no, get up there. Huh. Well, we're already here. Let's explore the peninsula here. That was nuts, right? Like, Cait. You hear that message? Like, they were host. Yeah, just hope that the person you work for never sends you on any stupid missions like that. I would never say piss off a giant Mirelurk behemoth or something. That is nothing I will ever ask you to deal with. Wink. Yeah, screw it. I can make it to the upstairs. Let's do this. I'm glad I did. See, Cait, they had a goodie box waiting for us.
Dropping some of that crap you're carrying.
Oh, I bet I'll drop it right into your waiting pockets.
Hey,
Butthead.
Now you're gonna be sharing that with both of us, right?
Yeah, sharing it right here. Watch. See? Shared. Light tower. Boathouse. Wait. Rule number one, avoid the water. Oh, sorry. Rule number one, know where the water is. Rule number two, avoid the water.
End of the line!
Okay. That's like the least efficient way you can get to their corpses. You're kidding me right now, Cait. Another one of these things. It's like a dolphin, but it's not. And this one is dead. Cool beans. Friend or foe? You know, I don't remember ever coming over here. God, there's a lot of game area to this game.
Are you
crazy? Get out of the street before any more of them catch wind of you. Look, I'll open the gate, and you get in here quick. I'm gonna let you in the bunker. Don't make me regret this.
Okay. Comes in, farts, laughs. Hi. Are we going in there? Don't be a creepy basement. Don't be a creepy nightmare basement. Don't be a creepy nightmare basement. Don't be a creepy dead. No creepy nightmare basement. Oh! Like a swell.
Lady,
swell survival basement.
Did someone drop you on your head as a baby?
This still looks cleaner than we placed back at the combat zone.
I know what a mire lurk is.
This place seemed empty. I thought everything was okay.
Okay? Do you go walking into every empty town you come across, assuming everything is going to be okay? It's amazing that you're not a corpse already. Luckily, I've got Reba here to help me crack those crabs wide open. Isn't that right, girl?
You seem busy.
I'm sorry if I caused any trouble.
Listen, don't let an old codger like me scare you. I'm old and I'm cranky and I haven't had a guest in months. Barney Rook, commander of the Salem Volunteer Militia, at your service.
Huh.
I'm also the quartermaster, sergeant-at-arms, and scribes for all official meetings. This here is Reba, but you two already met when she saved your life.
Is it just the two of you? Where is everyone else?
Wasn't always just two of us. Now, I'd love to sit here gabbing all day like a couple of housewives, but we've got some work to do. And by we, I most definitely mean you. Before you showed up, the Mirelurks had been mostly quiet, and those that were a problem were quickly dispatched by my turret defense system. Since things had been quiet lately, I took the turrets offline to conserve ammunition. Obviously, they need to be reactivated. And that's your mission, soldier. I'm going to continue to hold down the home front while you go reactivate the turrets.
You know what? He kind of does have a point.
Sounds good.
I'll help him out.
Of course it sounds good. I'm a tactical genius. The smartest man in town, as a matter of fact. The turrets should be easy enough to find. They're up high in strategic locations around town. Just be careful. All your noise probably woke up more crabbies and other mirelurks. The town could be crawling with them by now.
I really like this guy. Like, it's not that I'm okay with him being very, like, brusque and aggressive. It's just, he's in a survival situation. He is surviving. He's that kind of crazy that actually does survive, right? Okay. So the trick is going to be go to where I would place a turret and then repair the turrets that are likely already there waiting. Another one. Yeah. The bleed shotgun. this is going to be my tool for, like, the rest of the game. Oh, do I have to hit the... Okay, so you have to actually, like, go into a computer to turn them on. Do I need to shoot it that many times? Probably not. Oh, what are you? Oh, the bleed ignores armor. Auto stem chest piece?
Gotta be something of value on him.
What does mine do again? Because that sounds kind of rad. 19 and 19. I have a feeling that... Oof. I know this thing has a huge ammo capacity, but in case of shit going all to hell, I like to reload while I can. Oh, dude. You were holding out on me. Forget asking him for money for doing this. I got my pay. Ooh. Do we got pre-war money? Ooh, hello. Didn't move the bobby pin. Unlocked master lock. We are the champions, my friends. Bow, bow. Yeah, that's just in the stream right there. That's it. That's the best thing I will do for the rest of this hour.
Something's ghosting us.
Okay, this gun is kind of cheating, because that was with a shotgun from long range. Just blah, 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 blah. Was this a Call of Duty game? This was a full town at one point. Hey, Cait. Ah. One of my cats rubbed on my face earlier, and...
Find out what you need, and I'll get right on it. Time to
trade
a few things.
Nose itches, because I think a little bit of cat hair stayed on my face. Uh-oh. Fat man, too fat. Actually, how much... I have 7 whole mini nukes. You know, it hurts. We'll come back and look at the gear and stuff later. Which way do I think the door is? Sneaking around, and I'm like, why am I sneaking around? I should just stop. And then I'm like, no, don't say that, because the instant you do that, all of a sudden, like, a Mirelurk will have been hiding at the top of this freaking bell tower. I'm so resource rich at the moment that I'm like, I need to just break myself of looting as a habit, mostly altogether, like money, a couple items like pre-war money, caps, healing items, ammo, that kind of stuff is fine, but I really don't need most stuff. See, like that. Ooh. That's the first time I've seen an assault rifle drop. I've seen them start to show up in the vendors. Oh, I need to give this to her. Not enough weight. I just dropped a fat man in a missile launcher. I'm getting senile. That master difficulty lock. It's completely befuddled me, I think. Here. We'll fast travel and come back for him. Actually, I can just go ahead and do that right now. Make a quick trip back to Sanctuary. Dump stuff. Come back. They already have a system for letting you place stuff in the world. I really wish they would just go full ham with it and just let you,
A pleasure to see you again, ma'am. Are you ready to depart?
No, I want to talk to Cait.
Hey, what is...
Just let me have an item that I can activate to drop a box of some kind. Maybe there's like special positions that I can put them in. Whatever you want, game. I'll play to you. But the long and short of it is, I want to have the ability to drop off a whole bunch of stuff, mark it, and then like fire a flare and have the Minutemen show up and take it back for me.
Maybe I could carry some of that for you.
There we go. Armor you up a bit.
Never fear, ma'am. I will ensure your safety to the best of my ability.
Thank you, Ada. Let's put this in a more useful position. There we go. I saw an item earlier that I was really debating getting. It was a ripper. That could be a problem. Ooh, quest items aplenty. And a new issue of Grognak to go in the collection. Let's go pick up that fat man and that missile launcher and see what... Is it Barney? I think it was Barney. Was it Barney and Reba? I remember Reba specifically. Okay, this is coming at the town from a slightly different angle. Nothing in the cash register. Gonna try and not just pick up every single item I see. Kinda want to at times, but not going to. Self-control and all that. Yeah, this was totally a town. And not a long time ago, but recent. Jump out at me. I think what we've established with this shotgun is if I have a clear line of sight and have enough time to put rounds into you, I win. Let's maybe go a little light on the, save a little bit of that ammunition.
Hey, Barney.
You did it, didn't you? Huh? I could hear that sweet, sweet machine gun music all the way down here.
Did someone you drive almost a bulldozer
caught me
through
in
here?
Reba Midwalls.
Yeah.
No problem, Barney. Glad to be of service.
Well, Reba and I appreciate it. We won't soon forget you. Now, about that reward. Mm-hmm. Here's a key to my workshop in the bunker. Reba, too, should be sitting on the table in there. I'd say you earned her. Now, if you'll excuse
Reba
me,
too.
I believe today is earmarked for some target practice. The Salem Volunteer Militia never rests.
Want some help with that?
Oh.
Perfect.
Ah, okay. You know what? Reba 2's going up on the wall when I get back. Nothing I need. Yeah, okay. There we go.
Excellent.
I'm like, trying to keep my eye out for magazines and for, you're the odd bobblehead. We should head down the coast. See what's down that way. Because his is basically the point in this direction. Can I jump over this? I think I can. Okay, no. Some old boats. A buoy. Trucks, boats, boathouse. T- time for me and old Cait to head on down the road. And no, I don't mean old like that. It's an expression. Curious about that lighthouse, though. I am really forgetting rule number two. Little beachfront bathroom. Yep, nope. Hi, did somebody order an express? Whoa. Hello?
Embrace the glow.
I forgot about their rad weapons.
Hold up. You hear that?
Yeah, I hear it. It's gunfire, Cait. Sure.
We've got to do this more often.
Swore I heard something.
That's more like it.
God bless. Holy crap, Cait.
Over there. Get him. Found you again.
Oh, who would willingly live down here? Shit. Oh. But that's all it did. No. Nope. Actually, in. N-O-W-M-N-O-W-M-N-O.
I'm in.
Tower on the cliff. We will create a beacon to call forth Adam's children to rejoin us in the glow. Even the heretics shall be made precipitate in a great division. I kind of blew up the turrets, but...
Make that thing pour you a drink, and I'll be impressed.
Cait, at least your priorities are straight. Let's just hurry up and get this place looted before we have to bathe and rat away. Not saying I'm not going to anyway.
Yes.
Get the important stuff and get out. Okay. Oh, shit. Okay, Cait, let's go. Question. Would they have been aggressive to me if I hadn't hit their booby trap? Because I've gone and talked to the Children of the Atom before. For science, I'm gonna go down and check out. I'm gonna load back to that save I just made, because that's the canon save at the moment. Okay. I come in peace. Okay, no. They're just assholes. We've experimentally proven that they are assholes. Can't seem to disarm that.
I don't ask for much. Just need a full bottle and some bones to break.
Well, guess what? I'm gonna give you the later, and if you succeed at that, I'll give you the former.
You're gonna pay! Behold the faithful! I was just getting warmed up.
You know, I don't think Carter has a lot of moral high ground to stand on anymore, but I feel like radiation weapons is a line that she doesn't want to cross. It seems like a pretty good line. Here, take this vodka. If stalkers taught me anything, it'll help with the radiation. What did that... Oh, there it is. One of those things I can't disarm.
Just the wind. Hey. Be caught. You were mistaken, my child.
Perhaps Adam is testing me again.
Hmm?
The ball is at him. Is someone testing my faith?
Oh, that must have hurt.
Just illusions, no doubt put in my head by the faithless.
I think we have lost it.
Oh. I miss being able to target grenades using bats. Both to shoot grenades themselves and to throw them using bats. Keep going, Cait.
I'm all for taking all we can, but you're looking a little way down there.
Yeah, I know. Where's the guy? There's the guy I knocked out of the tower. Oh, man.
Hey.
Can you believe that crap? Bunch of, like, frankly terrifying religious fanatics. Whew. One of y'all got down in the water. Oh, there's like a sub here. I am one of the
Something's ghosting us.
Be cleansed!
Found you!
The water of his brilliance!
You know how to show a girl. A good time.
No, 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 no. I wasn't ready to be in the water. I am not. No.
Hey.
Yeah?
Don't do that to me, game.
Now you're gonna be sharing that with both of us, right?
That was not cool. They want this place. Radioactive barrels, big old light tower. Hey, we have a lighthouse now. I really need to turn a lot of these places into bases at this point, but whatever. Well, that's been our explorations of the Witch Museum, Barney's Place, and the Lighthouse. I need to double check. Like, I'm not convinced that there's not more you can do in Salem, but it does kind of seem like we've done all you can do. I don't know, we'll find out. Well, need to give Reva to her place. There we go. Well, that's been it for morning gaming today.
Find the men of science and institutes of learning.
Hi, Curie.
They are out there.
That's been it for morning gaming. I'm Michael Green, the counter jockey. Be awesome today, guys.
Excuse me. You have time to talk now. Still have something important to say.
Of course. What's on your mind?
Appreciate it. We've been on the road together for a while. And we've taken some hard knocks. But through all that crap, I notice you've always been sticking by me. You know, watching me back and making sure I don't do anything stupid. I think maybe it's time to tell you a little bit about who you're traveling with. There's no reason for us to keep acting like we're strangers.
It would be nice to know more about you.
You're saying that now. But when you hear me story, you might regret it. It all starts with two wastes of humanity, I suppose you could call me parents. I'm convinced I was a mistake, because I can't remember a single moment that they treated me like their daughter. I was yelled at and beaten. Everything I did was wrong. Nothing but a nuisance in their eyes. The whole time I was telling myself that they had to love me, even if it was just the tiniest bit, because they never kicked me out. Then me 18th birthday arrived, and I found out why they kept me around. They slapped a shock collar around me neck and sold me to slavers. They didn't even care enough about me to say goodbye. 18 years of suffering through that shite, and all I was worth to them was a pocket full of caps.
My God. I'm so sorry.
Thanks. But there is more to the story. It would be easy to blame me charming personality on me parents. But they didn't make me this way. I did. I was with those slavers for 5 years. Roughest five of me goddamn life. The things they made me do. The way they use me for their amusement. It sickens me to me stomach even thinking about it. But I bided me time and learned to use their own methods against them. Stealing a few caps out of a sleeping man's pocket is a piece of cake. As long as you don't get greedy.
I can't even imagine having to go through something like that.
You think that's low? Just wait. The story gets much worse. It took every ounce of patience I had. But after 5 years, I had finally pocketed enough to buy me own way out of there. But instead of heading off to try and repair the shambles of me life, I gave in to me rage and I headed home. You can imagine the look on me parents' faces when I kicked open their door. What you can't imagine is what they looked like after. After I emptied me gun into them.
You did what you had to do.
Did I? When I close me eyes, all I can see is their faces twisted with fear. And then my mind starts wandering and I start judging myself. And it's ripping me the fuck apart. You'd think I inject myself with all that shite and drink myself drunk because I'm a tough Irish girl. I do it so I can forget and move on with my miserable life. So there you are. The entire flawed package known as Cait. Stripped bare for your perusal.
Don't worry. I haven't lost faith in you.
I knew I was taking a chance telling you all this. I'm just glad I haven't disappointed you.
I'm always here for you, Cait. There's nothing you could say that would ever change that.
That's not what I expected you to say. Sorry. I didn't realize you cared that much about me. And here I thought I was being stupid, bothering you with me problems. It feels good to know if I need you, you'll be there for me. And I'll always be there for you, too.
Only thing better than getting pissed is picking a fight. Am I right?